I'm Rebecca Bridges, the County Administrator, and I'll be your mistress of ceremonies this morning.
Great, thank you all for coming this morning. And I will turn the podium over to Commissioner President Guy for opening remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Bridget. It's going to be short. It's been a long time getting here. You know, we started this almost 5 years ago, and our board, except for one, Mr. Colvin wasn't here at the time, but we're all here, and we saw a need immediately to do something about the size of the library and, of course, the location at which originally they were going to renovate and actually reduce usable space in the old library. And we said, this doesn't make sense. We got a community that's growing. We got to get this library situation straight. Also, I had the pleasure of working in the 2010 census, and one of the key things that I saw, being an older American, is that the elderly population in St. Mary's County, the state between 2010 and 2030, is growing by 125%. St. Mary's County, 245%. We have to get ready for things like that, and this is a start. The Garvey Senior Center will help us in that direction. You're going to have a large kitchen. The congregate meals and everything that we serve now in this county is to increase that type of production so we can continue on serving our senior citizens as we go on in life here. And of course, I'm one of them. And I'll be probably using the congregate meals more than these days myself. So I just got to commend all those who have worked hard to get us to this point. The Garvey Senior Center Council has been a big part in designing and helping to get this thing started. The library board and the library trustees, all of them have worked hard into getting this facility to the point it's at right now. And hopefully by March of next year, we'll have a huge grand opening. We're unable to get in there right now because they are working in there. It's a hard hat situation. We don't have enough hard hats to go around. So it wouldn't be fair for one or two of us to go and stay there. So I appreciate all those that worked hard to get where we're at today. And I thank the town of Leonardtown for working with us to get the zoning and everything done, stuff like that. So this is a joint effort from the entire county and all of the staff in making this happen. And I'm glad I was a part of it. I'm looking forward to the opening when it comes in March. And it'd be a great milestone for our Board of Commissioners. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner Guy. And next we'll hear from Carolyn Guy, President of the St. Mary's County Board.
Good morning. Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines progress in several ways. It's an expedition or a journey. It's forward or onward movement. Progress is also gradual betterment. The new Leonardtown Library itself could also be used as a definition of progress because it is an example of all three definitions in one project. The construction of this much-needed branch has been a decade-long journey. We've explored renovation and construction, struggled to find funding and support, and finally, our expedition, our journey, has led us to this site and this building. The new building positions St. Mary's County Library to lead our community into the future, with STEM programs to challenge the minds of our youth, story times to inspire our future leaders, and a welcoming place for everyone to be able to gather, immerse themselves in their favorite activities, and celebrate our freedom of speech. This new library will inspire gradual betterment of each member of the community who uses its services, either in person or online. Each member of our community, whether they seek to expand their knowledge of the world around them, seek peace and mindfulness to calm them, or seek one another to build a stronger St. Mary's, we'll start their own advancement here. Together, today, we celebrate our library and our progress. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Guy. And now we hear from Mary Lee Russell, the branch manager.
Wow. I could do a dance. I feel like doing a dance. It's hard to believe that I stood here May 15th, 2018, probably somewhere over there on a day just like this. It was absolutely gorgeous, and here we have another gorgeous day. And fingers crossed, in early March, we'll have another one when we open the doors, cut the ribbon, and walk into this beautiful facility. On that May 15th, 2018, we, St. Mary's County, the library community, had a plan, a design, and a vision that we believed this building would become. As you can see, this building is more than we could have hoped for. Our architects, Grimm and Parker, took what we described as a multi-purpose facility and literally service all ages, young and old, and together with the construction team, Tuckman and Barbie, they have worked tirelessly to make these dreams a reality. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This facility, a library and a senior center, will fulfill many promises made. It was built as a state-of-art building that blends with the future and the past, and we can hardly wait to open up the doors to the public. We know that this building will be a resource for all who walk in our doors. Every other week since construction began, we have had progress reports and participate in meetings and allow feedback and insight as the building has been taking shape. I have learned a lot about construction and some things I never knew that I should even really care about, such as soil, because when we started this building, it rained and it rained and it rained, and we would go to these meetings and you would learn about the different soils and how they drained and how they did not drain. And Gary, thank you so much for explaining all of that. We finally got there, but I also want to mention our team. I want to recognize Dean, Jimmy, Dave, Nate, Patrick, Antonio, Julia, Dan, Brian, Lori, Alice, Brandy, Dale, Michael, and Marianne. Thank you. This has been an awesome team to work with, meeting with you every 2 weeks, working together, all on the same page, and that is why we have what we have today. Thank you very much. And also, thank you, County Commissioners and our state delegation. It's with your help, the funding, that this absolutely is going to happen. It was so much needed in the Leonardtown Library, the 1954-year-old building that we are in right now, that I always say to the staff now, you only have a couple more months to go. We only have a couple more months to go. So thank you so much, along with the Friends of the St. Mary's County Library, our foundation, which we began 2 years ago, and we pulled together funding to purchase things in this building that we had only hoped to dream for. The town of Leonardtown, with your support, Tony comes to our meetings, he does things to make sure that we have all the utilities in place, and the many, many, many library supporters. This is a dream. You know, be so proud, County Commissioners, of this facility that we are now having for generations and generations of St. Mary's County residents to use. And on a personal note, if you remember, back in May, I said I had a new first grandchild, Jack. Well, Jack is going to be a year old in 2 weeks. Harper was born, and she'll be a year old in December. They've already attended baby story time, and they've told me, Mimi, we can't wait to come to the new library. So thank you so much. I can't wait to see you at the groundbreaking in a couple months.
Thank you, Mary. And now we'll hear from Gail Murdoch, Chairman of the Commission on Aging.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Commissioners, our guests, as she said, I am the chairman for the Commission on Aging. When the commissioners were presented with petitions signed and delivered to them, asking that they take action to move the construction of a new Garvey Senior Activity Center forward in the budget process, the commissioners held many hearings and a lot of work in Annapolis. I know that was not easy because I used to work in Annapolis with them. Got the funding approved for this new center. As we gather today to see all the progress made to date, it is obvious that we will soon have a new library and senior activity center ready for use. On behalf of the Commission on Aging members, we thank you, the commissioners, for making this dream come true. My speech is always short. I always say, let's get her done. Let's get this thing built.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Murdoch. And our last speaker this morning is Dale Taylor, president of the Garvey Senior Activity Center Council.
Good morning, everybody.
I'm going to segue
into what Mary Lee said. It was a year and 4 months ago that we stood on this ground right over there with shovels in our hand for groundbreaking for these new buildings. And this is a great day. None of this could have been possible without the tremendous support from a group of women and men. We called ourselves the Garvey Group, who were so instrumental in getting a groundswell of support from the citizens of St. Mary's County for a new Garvey Senior Activity Center. The Garvey Group eventually matured into a nonprofit organization, the Garvey Senior Activity Center Council Incorporated. I want to take the time to thank the Garvey Council members, please stand, for their dedication and time from the very beginning, which began 5 years ago, through today. These individuals continue to work tirelessly to support current activities at the Garvey Center, spend much of their time fundraising, that's our fundraising king, Gail Murdoch, kitchen support, and so much more. I just thank you so much for your support, and we have a great team. Thank you. Next, I want to thank our St. Mary's County Commissioners for approving the new Garvey Center and library buildings. We all thank you from the bottom of our heart. Seriously, it's what a day. And even you found the land, we didn't have to buy land. I mean, you saved a lot of money by finding land the county already owned. That was a really smart move there. But one thing I want to tell you is we are very fortunate to have a group of commissioners who are so supportive and listen to the county's needs. Thank you, commissioners. Another group of support is the Department of Public Works and Transportation. George Erickson, who then was the director of the department, provided support for the initial planning and design phase. After George took a new position with Metcom, Gary Whipple stepped up to the plate. Gary and his folks have been very supportive in keeping the team informed and current. Thank you both. We all see what we see today because of the progress we have worked as a team together. And also, I can't leave out Grimm and Parker, Antonio Ravello and his team. He's the director of design, and a big thank you for this beautiful external and internal design. This has proven to be that of a flagship design for the Garvey Center and Library. We all will be very proud of the new building once we stepped into the new Garvey Center and the Library. Once you go inside, you're going to go, wow, it's going to be amazing. Last but certainly not least, we thank Lori Jennings Harris. She's the director of the Department of Aging and Human Services. Alice Allen, she's the division manager for Senior Center Operations, and Brandy Tully, she's the program manager for the Garvey Senior Activity Center. These individuals have provided valuable insight and leadership from the beginning and continue to do so today. We thank each of you for your special and unique talents. I'm closing now. I'm trying to keep this under 2 minutes. We have all worked very hard, but we have worked well together as a very cohesive team to get where we are today. I am so very excited we have come so far. I am honored to have worked with such talented and dedicated women and men. The completion is now a very real vision in sight, and what a great team. Thank you, team, and I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'd also like to recognize Rachel Jones, who's joined us this morning from Senator Ben Cardin's office. Hi, Rachel. So finally, I'd like to turn your attention to the back of your program. The commissioners would like to give a special thanks to the Department of Aging and Human Services and the St. Mary's County Library Board of Trustees and the special folks that made this project happen. So I won't read all their names, but wanted you to make sure that you had an opportunity to see who they are. Finally, there's a gypsum board that we ask you to sign to dedicate today's closing in ceremony so that we have that for now and into the future.
Oh, no. If you do it, I'll walk up next to you. Oh, yeah. Do you want me to come up here? Next to you?
Thanks.
What?